Hey guys, so day 14 of the Red Letter Challenge. Today's reading comes out of John 8:7. Let any one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone. To display the shocking nature of grace, we are going to take a look at a story in John 8. You'll need to read the Bible story now to better understand the context of our devotion today. John 7:53 through 8:11. John 7:53. Then they all went home, but Jesus went to the Mount of Olives. At dawn, he appeared again in the temple courts where all the people gathered around him, and he sat down to teach them. The teachers of the law and the Pharisees brought in a woman caught in adultery. They made her stand before the group and said to Jesus, "Teacher, this woman was caught in the act of adultery. In the law, Moses commanded us to stone such a woman. Now what do you say?" They were using this question as a trap in order to have a basis for accusing him. But Jesus bent down and started to write something on the ground with his finger. When they kept on questioning him, he straightened up and said to them, "Let any one of you who is without sin be the first one to throw a stone at her." And again he stooped down and wrote on the ground. At this, those who heard began to go away one at a time, the older ones first, until only Jesus was left with the woman standing there. Jesus straightened up and asked her, "Woman, where are they? Has no one condemned you?" "No, sir, no one," she said. "Neither do I condemn you," Jesus declared. The Pharisees had spent months hatching the perfect plan to trap Jesus. This was the moment they were waiting for. "Jesus," they said, "the law tells us this woman has to be punished. What do you say?" This is a tough question. They've caught him in a contradiction in front of his disciples. If he answers, "Yes, stone her," that seems to go against everything he's been teaching. But if he says, "No, don't stone her," he would seem to be relaxing his morals. It's a tough question. But God can handle tough questions. These coming hypocrites were overmatched. Before Jesus answers, he bends down and doodles in the dirt with his finger. So they kept questioning him. And finally, Jesus responds to their inquiry. "Let any one of you who is without sin be the first to throw a stone at her." Silence comes on the crowd. Somehow, Jesus sneaked his way out of this situation. He goes back to doodling again on the ground, and all the people start leaving. Scholars have debated what Jesus wrote on the ground. Some think he was writing down a Bible verse. I'm sure he knew quite a few of them, right? Others think he was writing down some of the commandments. Others suggest he started writing down the names of the people who were standing in that circle holding stones and then listing their sins. It says the older ones left first. Why? Because they had the longest list, right? In a sense, Jesus was saying, "You want to talk about dirt? Let's talk about dirt. I know some stuff about you." The reality is there's only one person left who is without sin, and that's Jesus. What's he going to do? Sometimes people have the impression that God is out to get us or he's angry with us. Christians have been even known to advance this way of thinking. In fact, if I were to look at all the Christian billboards and signs, I'd think that God hated someone like me. I wouldn't want to come to church or approach him because he'd punish a person like me. I wouldn't want to come to church, or the roof might cave in on me after I've done wrong. But this is not what our God is. I'm sorry, but this is not who our God is. In fact, John 3:17 tells us that Jesus did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Jesus could have picked up a rock and thrown it at this woman. He would have been justified according to the law. But this is the story. Jesus' eyes are not focused on finding a rock. Instead, his eyes are filled with mercy and love for this woman. Jesus didn't begin by accusing her, and he's not going to start by accusing you. The devil will try to accuse you. He will throw rocks at you and remind you of all of what you've said and done and left undone. The problem is that many of us spend much more time listening to the accusations of the enemy than the truth of the gospel. The only one who had a rock to throw didn't even pick one up. Instead, Jesus got down on the dirt in front of her, and he got down in the dirt for you. He forgave my sins. He wiped my past clean. He clothed me with his righteousness. By his stripes, I am healed. God isn't afraid of your past. He's not afraid of where you've been and who you've hung out with. God loves you for who you are. He'll take you as you are. Some of you think that you're too dirty for God. When Jesus Christ died on the cross, he died for all the sins of every man and woman who has ever lived, is living, and will ever live. You have to be forgiven. And as forgiven people, we are to emulate Jesus. If Jesus dropped his rock for us, we need to drop our rocks as well. We are here to help others, help save others, and not to condemn them. Drop your rock for others and for yourself. Can you forgive others? What about forgiving yourself? If you're still holding on to things you've done, if you think sin is too great for him to forgive, you are actually stripping away the power of the cross. Jesus came to seek and to save those who are lost, and that includes all of us. Challenge and reflection. This is the day to drop our rocks. Most of us have certain sins that really bother us. Which sins do you elevate above the rest? Write those sins on a rock and pray that you are able to see all people, no matter what their sin might be, as candidates for the grace of Jesus Christ. So you guys can't write your sins on the rock on the next page like this tells us to. So what I'm telling you to do is whatever sin really bothers you the most, whether it's yours or somebody else's, I want you to write it on a rock, and I want you to throw that rock as far as you can out in the middle of a field or a gully or a ditch or whatever it is, okay? Hey guys, so for today's challenge, I want you to comment on what my shirt is all about.